Hello friends, welcome back on SSB Rocks. In this video we will cover Indo-Nepal relations. The knowledge of this topic will help you in your lecturette and group discussion. If you want detailed information on any subject or topic in the form of knowledgeable video like this, feel free to contact us or just mention the topic in the comment box below. For more practice, subscribe SSB Rocks and don't forget to like, share and recommend SSB Rocks to your friends, and don't forget to hit bell icon to get the notification of the next knowledgeable video. So friends, let's get started. Introduction. Close bonds between the two countries, India and Nepal, share many common bonds, historical and geographical, cultural and economic. India and Nepal have wide-ranging cooperation, including large development projects in the infrastructure, rural, health and community welfare sectors. With Nepal becoming a republic after 240 years of monarchy, India has to deal with a new Nepal. In order to make India's engagement with a new Nepal constructive and mutually beneficial, there is a need to understand the radical transformation Nepal has undergone in recent years. An upsurge of socio-economic aspirations, rise of people's power and spread of political consciousness at the grassroots has been witnessed in Nepal. Background. Indo-Nepalese Accord of Peace and Friendship. The 1950 accord stated that neither government shall tolerate any threat to the security of the other by a foreign aggressor, and obligated both sides to inform each other of any serious friction or misunderstanding with any neighboring state likely to cause any breach in the friendly relations subsisting between the two governments. These accords cemented a special relationship between India and Nepal that granted Nepal preferential economic treatment and provided Nepalese in India the same economic and educational opportunities as Indian citizens. Nepal insists that the treaty was signed in haste and should be modified to suit the present circumstances. Water sharing of the Mahakali River. The Mahakali River Accord was signed in 1996 and provided for the development of the Mahakali Basin. It envisaged the construction of 2000 megawatts hydroelectric project in Nepal along the development of the Tanakpur and Sharda barrages and construction of 22 bridges in the Kolhapur-Mahakali area inside Nepal. The treaty will result in power generation at a low cost. The basin development will immensely benefit both the countries. The treaty also accommodates Nepal's main demand that it should benefit from the Tanakpur project as a matter of right and not as a gift, and in recognition of its contribution in the form of land for the left Afleksband. Political and security concerns for India. Porous border. India has an open and porous border with Nepal, and terrorist elements cross over into Indian territory. However, India is vigilant to the threat of terrorism and will not allow its territory to be used by forces inimical to the people of Nepal. According to the spokeswoman of the Ministry of External Affairs, fertile ground for violence, the disturbances in Nepal can create serious political and security problems for India. The floating Nepalese population between India, Nepal and Bhutan, with an indeterminate national identity, will provide fertile ground for violence and other crimes. Opportunities for Pakistan's inter-service intelligence (SSI). An unstable Nepal would also provide opportunities to Pakistan's inter-service intelligence (SSI) and terrorist and separatist elements from the India's northeast. Detrimental effect on Indo-Nepal and Sino-Indian relations. Nepal is a buffer state between India and China. The turmoil in Nepal could get enmeshed in foreign policy and security decisions, which could have detrimental effect on Indo-Nepal and Sino-Indian relations. Complex security dimensions. The security dimensions for India in relation to Nepal are complex and influenced by the district geography of the landlocked country. Although the China factor is a perennial challenge to India, recent trends, however, suggest that the Chinese may not encourage and zero-sum approaches in the region. Use of Nepal's territory by external forces for anti-India activities. Pakistan's SSI is perceived to be highly active in Nepal, and the hijacking of Indian Airlines flight from Kathmandu in December 1999 is case in point. Providing operational and logistical assistance to Nepal. India can provide Nepal with operational and logistical assistance to make the counter-insurgency operations successful. This support and cooperation is necessary in view of the long-term productive potential of bilateral cooperation between the two countries. Nepal's new constitution. Nepal's parliament has overwhelmingly approved a new constitution. The new constitution was passed by a 507-25 vote in the 601-seat Constituent Assembly, CA, after the voting and came into effect on the 20th of September 2015. It should be noted that this is the fifth constitution enacted by Nepal. The previous four constitutions were enacted in 1959, 1962, 1990 and 1999. The main features of Nepal's new constitution are: 1. Establishes Nepal as secular and federal democratic republic. It moves away from the existing unitary structure. 2. The constitution vests executive rights of the country on the Council of Ministers headed by Prime Minister. The president would be ceremonial head of the state. 3. It establishes bicameral federal parliament and split the country into seven federal provinces. It establishes competitive multi-party democratic system with periodic elections. 4. Enshrines fundamental rights. Civic freedom, human rights, voting rights and full press freedom etc. To its citizens. It establishes independent, fair and competent judiciary in order to build the nation with the commitment to socialism based on rule of law and democratic norms and values. India's concerns on the new constitution ignored. Nepal went ahead with the new constitution. Despite India's concerns to ensure that the members of the Madhesi and Tharu communities, which have refused to sign the constitution, are brought on board first. Nepal shares India's concerns about making sure the constitution was all-inclusive. But at the end, that was the internal process of Nepal. And the constitution document was a result of 8 years of negotiations, following the best internationally accepted practices. According to Nepal's foreign affairs advisor Dinesh Bhattarai, Nepal's fuel agreement with China. The main features are: 1. On October 28, 2015, Nepal signed its first fuel agreement with China for the supply of petroleum to ease the crippling shortage after protests by Madhesi groups blocked imports from its sole supplier India. 2. On October 29, 2015, China's foreign ministry spokesperson said that the Chinese government decided to supply Nepal with a certain amount of emergency fuel assistance so as to help Nepal to tide over its fuel shortage. China had already agreed to donate 1.3 million liters of petrol to Nepal. 3. The shortages of fuel prompted the government of Nepal to turn to China for help, ending decades-long monopoly by India and increasing tensions between the two neighbors, according to analysts. 4. Analysts point out that the fuel agreement with Nepal is in line with China's strategic perspective, with Nepal as one of the nodes of the China-led Belt and Road Connectivity Initiative that would integrate the economies of Eurasia. 5. China and Nepal have signed a four-point document endorsing the Belt and Road Initiative. Current situation: Nepal new Prime Minister, Pushpa Kamal Dahal, with effect from the 3rd of August 2016. Background: the Prime Minister's post was vacant since the 24th of July 2016 when Communist Party of Nepal Unified Marxist-Leninist, CPNUML, Chairman K.P. Sharma Oli resigned. Prachanda was the Prime Minister from 2008 to 2009 before a disagreement with the military over his attempt to sack the army chief brought his tenure to an end. Challenges faced by the new Prime Minister: whether CPN Maoist Chairman Prachanda will be successful as PM this time largely depends on how he deals with the challenges as given in the succeeding paragraphs. Constitutional amendment: the ruling Nepali Congress, NC, Maoist coalition has reached a three-point deal with the Madhesi front that include acknowledging those killed during the Madhesi agitation as martyrs and providing free treatment to the injured, besides amending the constitution to redraw provincial boundary, which would be Prachanda's biggest challenge. Without the CPNUML's support, it would be difficult to address Madhesi issues by amending the constitution. And securing the UML's consent would be very difficult. Implementation of the constitution: the constitution categorically stipulates that local, federal and parliamentary elections will have to be held before December 2017. But without revising a number of laws in the constitution, it would not be possible to hold any elections. Determining the number and areas of local administration within federal provinces is also tricky. Madhesi parties have refused to take part in any elections unless their political demands are met. Peace process: even in 2008, when he became PM for the first time, Prachanda could not use his power to nullify 6,000 legal cases pending against him. other Maoist leaders and cadre. He faces tremendous pressure from within his party to act on this critical issue. He needs to protect his comrades while respecting international norms of transitional justice. Alliance with the NC. Prachanda is the chairman of the third largest party and has become PM with the backing of the largest party, the NC. Ministers representing the NC in the government might not obey him. And it will be difficult for him to retain the NC president Sher Bahadur Deoba's trust. Reconstruction. Prachanda's predecessors, Sushil Koirala and K.P. Oli, were criticized for not acting swiftly to help post-2015 earthquake recovery. Now, he will have to prove that he is different and cares for the poor earthquake survivors while ensuring good governance. Balanced diplomacy. 1. In March 2016, former Prime Minister Oli signed the trade and transit agreements with China, which include China building an international airport at Pokhara, where it would set up a consulate soon. The Chinese President Xi Jinping's visit to Kathmandu on the precondition that he would visit Nepal in a few months only if there is political stability in the country, was looking possible. 2. If Chinese President Xi does not visit Nepal or Prachanda fails to make progress in implementing the transit deal, it will be considered his failure. 3. On the other hand, seen in the light of China's growing engagement with Nepal, to the detriment of India, President Xi's visit would be a milestone. 4. Both Indian as well as Chinese governments congratulated Prachanda on assuming the office of PM. In fact, PM Modi spoke to Prachanda on telephone, congratulated him and also invited him to visit India. 5. Prachanda has to balance this with India's sensitivity about closeness with China. It will be an uphill task for him to maintain equidistance with Beijing and New Delhi. Thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, please hit like button, and for more practice of other aspects of SSB, subscribe SSB Rocks. Friends, you can join us on our Telegram and WhatsApp group as link given in description below. You can also join our Facebook group for group discussion on various aspects of SSB. The link of the same is also given in description below. All the best SSB Rocks.